Don't take it too seriously, just laugh. Spend the new year with the Edo citizens. Welcome to Andrea's Academy. In this Japanese cultural and historical video, we explore how someone from the Edo period would celebrate the new year. In the Chinese zodiac, which is also used in Japan, 2024 marks the year of the dragon. So, as the new year approaches, you'll notice many dragon motifs around Japan. Also, the old Japanese calendar dated the new year near February, such as nowadays Chinese calendar. Look at this cute dragon holding a mandarin orange and sitting on a rice cake. You can buy this offering for the deities in any modern Japanese supermarket. Don't forget this information. We need this later. Now let's rewind to the mid-Edo period, specifically in Tenmei 4th year, 1784. They were also ringing the bell in the Year of the Dragon. Now here's the fun fact. During this time, humorous poems called Kyoka were all the rage, influencing jocular literature like Kibyōshi. Yellow cover booklets were picture books with humorous content similar to today's comics. They were published in the new year to bring good luck by starting the new year with laughter. In 1784, a strange form of these booklets appeared, mixing humorous poems in. Regarding the text, it's full of alludes and it's in old Japanese anyway, so let's just take a look at the illustrations. Our first booklet is New Year's Greeting Register, and it shows us that these customs haven't changed so much since then. You can observe pine trees adorning house entrances, as well as rice cakes and dragon raising, as I showed you before. However, this yellow cover booklet is not really about customs, but rather about the era's economical and political situation, which were famous for bribery under the minister of Danuma Okitsugu. So all these pictures are exaggerated. Rice cakes are typically offered for deities on New Year's, but in this description we observe a very large rice cake. Why, you may ask? Well, it's a big bribery. If you were an Edo citizen, you'd find it quite amusing. If this isn't enough, here's a poem from the text for you. Mochikuchi no sashi mo kataki o kuitomeshi gusoku no sonae iwau medetasu. In this kyoka, the humor stems from playfully blending the tradition of New Year's celebration with the imagery of a formidable foe. Not only on New Year's, but Edo citizens loved culinary delights, especially men who thought about themselves as in fashion. The narrative of Pete Cake delves into a historical story of a restaurant flourished before the 1780s. However, on the surface, it portrays an older historical story, the Keian Uprising, and transforms it into a culinary competition. So what made Edo citizens laugh? Just look at the picture where people with vegetable head chasing the other part of the army. The people of Edo knew exactly who were the real person who was portrayed with radish head. And that was quite amusing. Both works introduced in this video were written by Ōta Nanpo, a prominent poet of the Tenmei Kyoka boom. Interestingly, Nanpo was a hobbyist poet and writer, and he held his main position as a samurai in the shogun's service on a very high rank of the dominion accountant. The question arises, how could a samurai freely engage in such a creative activities in a supposedly strict Japanese feudal society? Was the Edo era society truly as rigid as it often perceived? Stay tuned to my channel and I provide answers sooner or later. Are you interested in the Kibyōshi or Kyoka's English translation? I really recommend you to check out Adam L. Kern's or Haruo Shirane's works. For more details, check out the video description. Now that's all for today. I wish you a happy new year filled with laughter and happiness.